Hello and welcome to Let's Play Baldur's Gate, Enhanced Edition. I'm Amethyst Lunatari, the RPG chick, and now I'm actually rolling a character. Don't be confused about the previous episode where I'm playing the Enhanced Edition, but yet you saw a movie from the classic game, or something that looks different from what you know from the Enhanced Edition, because I have the Baldur's Gate Enhanced Edition Classic Movies mod installed. I really dislike the Beamdog movies. Sorry. I know some may like them, but in comparison to the originals, it's just... No. No thanks. So you see continue here, because I was testing. This game, even though I'm labeling everything blind, that's just for simplicity's sake. I have played quite a bit of the game. Up to, but not including the Nashkel town. So options, I'm gonna change this stuff. You guys might want to see this stuff here. Actually, I need to turn something back on. Language, yeah, show subtitles. I had that off. It messes up the classic movies. It shows the subtitles, but late to compared to when the characters say them, because the intro has been redone, so I don't know, it messes everything up. So turn that back on. Hopefully it's not confusing during future movies. Story mode, no. Easy difficulty. Cannot die in combat. Nope. Highlight accessible terrain on the area map. Right. Gore, yes. Weather, yes. Group info vision. Rest until healed. I might take advantage of this. That's a little bit cheating. Although it does stink when you get a level up and you get 1 point. Keyboard skull speed, difficulty. I think I'm on so wait, normal. Okay, so I'm on normal. All hit point rolls are maximum. Really? Party members cannot permanently die. I think that means that you can cast Raise Dead and stuff. All spells are learned automatically, and opponents do 3/4 damage against the party. You know, I want to check on that. Normal difficulty. Look at that, plus 6 luck for that. Party members can permanently die. Spell learning has a chance to fail. See, I don't like that. I go through enough of that with freaking Amber Star. Oh, that's the gameplay. Alright. Now, because I have Lefruit's classic UI, enhanced UI, is gonna look different from your... Probably from your version of Baldur's Gate Enhanced Edition. Full screen or mouse cursor, scroll user interface. Zoom look, sprite outlines. Yeah, I don't like the way the outlines look. Grayscale and pause. Grays out the screen when pause, blah blah blah. Highlights look to screen dither. There's more. HP, health bars, scroll out of bounds. Alternate renderer. Yeah. Hopefully we won't have any problem with the default renderer. And here's all the movies you can actually play, all the original movies. So yeah, we're not continuing, because it's a character I made just as a test. I'm gonna go single player, but I'm gonna make sure, I'm gonna check what they mean by character cannot permanently die. Because I don't want my characters to all come back up after the, you know, after the combat's over. I would do want them to be able to die. So, but I want them to be able to be resurrected, raised dead, what have you. So I'll be back. Okay, with some deliberation, I'm going to play on the core rules, which is here. Well, this is much easier to scroll this way. So, easy, normal, core rules, hard, insane. So, easy, normal, core rules, it's insane. So I'm going to go with that, and there is a few more things here that I missed. Colored selection circles. This might make things easier to pick out, because sometimes it's hard to see characters when they're all bunched together like that, so I'm going to turn that on. Can you have both? Classic selection and colored? More confirmation prompts, at least to begin with. Characters go through attack animations right around to simulate feigning and dodging. I'll leave that on. Don't melee after depleting one ammo stack. Yeah, that's something that... I'm gonna leave that on. So, and this has to do from taking more damage and difficulty settings higher than core rules. So it shouldn't apply, but I'm gonna check it anyway. No max HP, this I might turn on, this is it. Oh. Yeah, don't stretch the UI, I hate that. Reset the zoom level. Is this what we don't like? Linear scaling method smooths out the sprites for a softer, slightly out of focus look. Disable it. I'm gonna turn this on. Because what I heard after version 1.3, when they came out 2.0 or 2.5 or whatever it was, the sprites had a washed out look to them. So I'm not sure if that has to do. But yeah, this is all subject to change, guys. So I'm just trying to provide the best experience possible for you and I. So single player. New game. Gender. Female. Now... Oh, it didn't go down all the way, did it? There we go. This is my blonde. This is the small version. That's why it's... look the same, pretty much. This is the large, and this is the small. This one, I kind of was playing around with, but it looks different from the other characters, does it? I don't know. We'll stay with this. Race. Elf or half elf? Now the good thing is you can't tell here, although her face doesn't look elven, but you can't see the ears. You can go either way, really. ...90% resistance against charm and sleep, infravision. Plus one Thaco bonus with bows, short swords, and long swords is not going to apply to my character. I am playing a mage. Minus 5 open locks, plus 5 pickpockets. Plus 5 moves silently, hide in shadows, dex. Plus 1 dex, minus 1 con. I'm gonna go with elf then. Why not? Class! Mage. Oh, I don't have my... I have a timer on, and it was not on. Okay. May only become proficient in any... one slot in any weapon class. Gonna be sling. I'm gonna place any slots in the fighting style because their game spells. D4, this is gonna be tough. Especially on cool rules, but. I think it'll be fun. Okay, so we've got mage, basically. Diviner. Or diviner. Detection and divining or divining magics. Yeah. We need a high wisdom for that too. Enchanter. One additional spell per level. Plus 2 bonus for making saving throws against enchantment school spells. Target suffer a minus 2 penalty when making saving throws against spells. Enchantment. What? Wait. Does that make sense? You're an enchanter. Okay, so you're a target, meaning not yourself. Okay, targets. Alright. May not learn or cast any spells in the invocation school. No fireball. I'm out. We got wild mage. Wild mage is interesting. It's really a wild card. You know, things can go incredibly right or things can go incredibly wrong. Extremely unpredictable and should be used with caution. Wild Surge generates a completely random magical effect from the spell being cast. Its effects may be either beneficial or detrimental to the Wild Mage and her allies. So, yeah. It is interesting, but I think I'll stick with the default mage. Chaos Shield. Improved Chaos Shield. 5% chance of incurring a wild surge. It's always going to happen at the worst possible time, I'm sure. Alright. Alignment. Chaotic good. Got a good character. It's a strong individualist marked by a streak of kindness and benevolence. They believe in all the virtues of goodness and right, but they have little use for laws and regulations. They have no use for people who try to push folk around and tell them what to do. Their actions are guided by their own moral compass, which, although good, may not always be in perfect agreement with the rest of society. A brave frontiersman forever moving on as settlers follow in his wake, an example of a chaotic good character. It's basically my default alignment for everything, including real life, pretty much. Abilities. Okay, here's where we roll. You can try to get as close to 90 as possible. Over 90? Freaking awesome. So I'm not gonna go crazy because I'm recording here. Because I don't have a lot of patience for this stuff. Not bad. 84, store that. Although I do want to get higher than that. Another 84. Now what I hate is when you breeze past it, you get like 100 and then, oops, I press re-roll again. It's gone forever. So I'm gonna be careful not to click too fast. But there are people who literally rolled hours. Plus you could just go in and hack the files and such. to give yourself a great score. But that's not very sporting, is it? 83, 84 again. Come on, we do higher than 84. Sold for 84. 91! That's nice. I'm just gonna try for a little bit more because 91 is pretty damn good. I think the highest you can get is 110? Alright. They've got 6 scores. Which can all go as high as 18. One oh eight is the highest. And yes, I totally did use a little calculator app to do that. But 91 is pretty sweet. I'm happy with that. So as I speak, Baldur's Gate 3 has yet to be released, or even have a release date beyond just 2019. So I'm really excited to get into that, but first, this game, Siege of Dragonspear and Baldur's Gate 2. So if anyone wants background info on how I play these games, my plans for the LP, the mods I have installed, and my experience with the game, watch my Let's Play Part 0. That's all I gotta say. I read all the things. I play slowly, deliberately, what's the other word, methodically. I want to explore all content, all quests that pertain to my character anyway. I'm not going to be taking on, like, a lot of evil quests, or maybe and not any evil quests. But other than that, I will attempt to talk to everybody, explore every area possible. And I'll be reading item descriptions, dialogue that is not voiced, of course. Basically anything. Not getting another 90 something. And it could be fun actually to play with lower stats to begin with. There are a lot of people who have played this game in very different ways. I'm gonna give yourself a challenge. Play with like really low stats. So they're planning on, well, in a few months from now, they're gonna be releasing Baldur's Gate 1 and 2 on consoles. I wonder if they're gonna be doing that with Siege of Dragonspear as well. I imagine so. And then Baldur's Gate 3 coming out. Totally not planned by me. I've been planning on playing this for quite a while. So, when all this news happened, I'm like, yeah, I really better get on this. Otherwise, you never know. I might have slipped in another game before this, because this is a long haul here. Yeah, I think I'm just gonna go with the 91. That is pretty decent, I think. 91! So as a mage, you don't really need strength, so I'm just gonna take that away. Con is good. Does it start to tell you when you increase? Yeah. I'm already 18 with intelligence, look at that. Enlightenment, judgment, and common sense. Now it's interesting, animals have a high wisdom score, but low intelligence. I wish you could see the... Stand by, guys. I want to check my ability rules here. Okay. I have the tables here. And I don't consider it cheating because you'd see this in a... Player's Guide or Dungeon Master's Guide, possibly. With Dexterity... Get armor class adjustment. So if this is correct, my intelligence is already at 18. 16 of plus 1. No. Actually it's minus 1 because you're Thaco here. So minus 1 at 15. Minus 2 at 16. You go up to 17 for a minus 3. That's gonna help. Basically, with a wizard, you cannot use armor, so it's a good thing. And... Constitution... grants a hit point adjustment. Number that is added from the gain of hit points when the character reaches a new level. Only applied for the first 10 levels for rogues, priests, and wizards. So, constitution here. Is plus 1. Starting at 15. Plus 2 at 16. So I have plus 2 here, so which means I'll get an extra, should be, from what I understand anyway, by default for a mage, 1d4. So now I'm gonna get 1d4 plus 2 per level, if I'm right in this. So intelligence, I can't put it any higher than this. Wisdom is always good as well. But do I want to decrease anything else? See, wisdom affects your lore. Bonuses begin at 15. Sorry guys, just looking at this. Bonuses begin at 15, so let me have the bonus. And then charisma. Bonus discount when buying goods. Maybe a few instances where you can avoid a difficult fight purely through dialogue. Bonuses to NPC reaction begin at 13. So, I've pretty much gone over everything except for strength. Strength, the only thing that strength helps in this case. Am I looking at the right thing? Yeah. is your weight allowance. Here at 11, I have a weight allowance of 70 and a bashing percent of 10. It's the same at 10 strength. But at 12, we go up to a weight allowance of 90 and bashing percent of 12. The percent is like nothing. But you can carry an extra 20 pounds. But then again, you're going to have characters who can carry your stuff for you. So, should I decrease it to 10? Or do lower something else to get up to 'carry more weight. I mean, it's really only applies to fighter types. Generally speaking, do not go below 10. I just want to check one other thing. Okay. So I've determined I'm going to keep my stats like this and put my one extra point into wisdom. Basically, putting strength up to 11 will not help. Putting dex up higher than 16 won't help. I need to go to 19, I think. Maybe not even then. Constitution. Yeah, you don't get an extra point, I believe. I could be wrong on some of this stuff. Intelligence is maxed out. Wisdom, I just put in here. You get a lore bonus. Here would be plus 3%. Here is plus 5%. So I'll just do that. And then charisma, I'll just leave as is. So, done. And skills. Basically, I put it into the sling. I do not want to melee with this character. Because I am intelligent. Can't say I have 18 intelligence. As compared in real life, anyway. Although the sling is commonly thought of as a toy weapon, its lethality should not be underestimated. A strong bullet thrown from a sling by an experienced user can tear a hole through a man's skull. Not sure if I'll be doing any of that, except with spells. Oh! You may choose two spells to put in your spellbook. These will be the spells your character currently has knowledge of beginning of the game. Specialist mage spells that belong to their school have a green outline on them. You must pick one of those spells before continuing on. Pick for me. No thank you. I believe I want sleep. I had a list of spells written down that probably magic missile and sleep. And I'm probably gonna look at something and still determine that those are the two I want, but where the hell did I put that? Wait, I think I found it. Okay. The armor is good. Magical field of force serves as if you wear a scale mail armor, which is equal to AC 6, etc. Blind is good. Oh, blindness. Temporarily blinds its target. Minus 4 penalty to attack rolls and armor class, as long as they fail the save. That's a good one, too. Charm. Includes any bipedal human. Blah, 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 blah. It also counters charm. chromatic orb is good. It levels up. I like things that can level up with you. Find familiar. I think you can find this spell somewhere early in the game. I do want a familiar, but it's not priority, and I think you can find the spell somewhere early in the game anyway. You can buy all or most of them anyway, but I think you can find this one. We'll find out. We'll find familiar. Grease is also good. Seems to be an underused spell. Any creature entering the area or caught in it when the spell is cast must save versus a spell at +2, or slip and slide, unable to move effectively. Sure, there'll be some comedic results. Identify. Becomes a valuable spell as you go on. Yeah. I have magic missile and sleep. Circled. Well, the great thing is that Magic Missile also levels up with you, and it's a guaranteed hit. There is no saving throw. There is no chance to miss. 1d4 plus 1 points of damage, and for every 2 levels, you get an additional missile. Up to a total of 5 missiles at 9th level. Sweet! Just want to look at that, not undo it. Comatose slumber, come upon one or more enemies. All creatures to be affected by a sleep spell must be within 15 feet radius. Saving throw versus death with a -3 penalty or fall asleep. Monsters with 5 hit die or more are unaffected. So, once you get into higher levels, this is useless because you'll be fighting a lot of 5 hit die monsters. So we got sleep. Magic missile. Done. Spell remaining. 1. Could be because of high intelligence. I'm not sure. You may memorize 1 spell. Oh, wait. No, this is memorizing. Alright, so I can memorize 1. Magic missile. There you go. How sad. This is how you start. I think we get something minor drain or something. Appearance. My hair is blonde. It is horrible. Doesn't seem to be. See, that does not look like that. We'll go with that for hair. Skin. Yeah, we'll go with that for skin. Major, minor, right? Why does black not seem to be an option? It can be very colorful, or not. Oh, that looks black. Okay, I listen to these. No thanks.
Your life shall be mine.
This one I like. Not elderly.
Go, go, go!
Not really commanding.
Now you're going to be sorry!
That's like an Imowen type voice, isn't it?
Who's in for it now?
Relaxed?
You don't stand a chance.
Do I like that one? Oh, I think I found his voice annoying.
Oh, this is such an honor. I don't know what to say. Wait. Yeah, I do. Follow me. Oh, we've done so much today. Maybe it's time for a quick nap.
Doesn't sound that relaxed to me.
What are we just standing around for? Golden glory isn't going to rain from the sky, you know.
Kinda has a regal yet not... I don't know. But anyway, it is scholarly.
Your doom approaches.
To me, that's dark. That doesn't sound scholarly.
Do as I say, and we will thrive.
Alright, so what I like is streetwise.
Your life shall be mine.
That sounds rather evil, however.
I deserve to be leader. We should rest now. I need sleep.
I'm gonna go with that for my character. So this character's name... In Skyrim, I played Amethyst. In Enderal, you're playing Topaz. So, might as well name my character Sapphire. Except... Oh, here we got more. Didn't I change the core rules already? Venture forth.
Nestled atop the cliffs that rise from the Sword Coast, the Citadel of Candlekeep houses the finest and most comprehensive collection of writings on the face of Faerûn. It is an imposing fortress, kept in strict isolation from the intrigues that occasionally plague the rest of the Forgotten Realms. It is secluded, highly regimented, and it is home. Within these hallowed halls of knowledge, your story begins. You have spent most of your 20 years of life within this keep's austere walls, under the tutelage of the sage Gorion. Acting as your father, he has raised you on a thousand tales of heroes and monsters, lovers and infidels, battles and tragedies. However, one story was always left untold. That of your true heritage. You have been told that you are an orphan, but your past is largely unknown. Lately, Gorion has been growing distant from you, as if some grave matter weighs heavily on his heart. You have asked about his concerns as gently as possible, but your queries have been in vain. Your sole comfort is the knowledge that he is a wise man, and you know he will tell you when the time is right. Nonetheless, his silence is troubling, and you cannot help but feel that something is terribly wrong. Today, Gorion has appeared more agitated than ever, and now he has uncharacteristically interrupted your chores in the middle of the day. Imparting hurried instructions for you to equip yourself for travel, he has handed you what gold he can spare, but given no clue as to why. Nevertheless, you now stand before the Candlekeep Inn, ready to purchase what you need for an unplanned and unexpected journey.
Welcome to Candlekeep, your home. As you move around the keep, you will find green-robed monks. Your character should walk over and talk with them. Many important messages will be given to you through the text window at the bottom of the screen. To expand and contract this window, simply drag the top to desired height, such as that. Okay, so I think we're going to call an episode here, believe it or not, just character creation, generation. I figured that would be the gist of this episode. Next episode, guys, Candlekeep. Thanks for watching, see you next time, and always... Sick adventure.